Welcome to the Beyond Cinema and Bio.com studio up here at TIFF. Messieurs Benson and Moorhead and Nadia Hilker. Firstly, just, you know, congrats on being here. Second film, Toronto. It's obviously a big achievement. But this one you went a little bit more international than the first. What drew you to kind of putting together such a kind of international kind of piece? Like bringing in, like shooting in Italy and bringing in Nadia from, you know.
I mean, have you ever been internationally? It's beautiful.
Yeah.
I mean, I think that that's probably, the appeal of the project wasn't like, okay, we're going to go to Italy. I mean, he wrote it, like, for Italy.
Yeah.
So it made sense.
It was actually really naive. It was written when we were mixing our last movie Resolution, and we knew even less than we know now. And really, if you go tell producers you want to go shoot in Italy, usually it's like, you can't, impossible, too expensive, indie film. Where we ended up shooting, it turned out to be the easiest thing in the world, the best crew we've ever had. But really, the way that whole international production came together, which is being naive and sort of being in post on Resolution and being like, wouldn't it be cool to go travel? So let's just write a movie that takes place in the places we'd like to go.
Yeah, the movie's really, like, it's a big story with a very, very small, like very intimate, you know? So we had this idea in our heads that, like, maybe we could just go make it. Like, just go make it, you know what I mean? Like, grab a camera and run off. And because we always have that fantasy of, you know, indie filmmakers, like, no one tells us what to do, you know, that kind of thing. And then, you know, actually trying to make the movie, it's like, oh, yeah, that's right, we need to make a real movie, you know? Like, and so that was, you know, we're like, we can travel, we could backpack and, like, you know, go do this thing. But then, of course, you know, when you want to increase your scope and make, like, a professional product, that's when you gotta
end up, especially coming from Resolution, which was just kind of also very singularly focused, you know, mm-hmm. very kind of claustrophobic at times, you know.
In a lot of ways, though, Spring is still a lot like Resolution in that it's, you know, very much about one central relationship. It's in this one town, not in the one building like Resolution, but it's in the same town pretty much the entire time. We took over that whole town, they threw their doors open to us, and the film commission, you know, of course, just scouted the whole place with us and gave us some financial incentives and everything. So that was kind of like a perfect little, is a perfect follow-up to Resolution in terms of scope, because one was still, it's still little, it's not like a big globe-trotting thing,
yeah.
Except our, you know, road-trippy third act, so.
What city was it?
It was called Polignano a Mare in the Apulia region of Italy.
So the Apulia Film Commission were the guys who kind of helped you out.
Yeah.
Was that something that was a kind of new experience for you too, just having these kind of extra sets of eyes and hands?
Oh my gosh, yeah. Yeah, I would say so. I don't think we've ever had anybody looking out for us except for our like main crew and stuff like that. But then once they came on board, they really helped us out.
And how did you find Nadia?
We basically, for one thing, it was really hard to find someone to play this particular role because there's a story reason why she can't exactly be placed ethnically, both visually and her accent. And, you know, it's an actor's job to learn accents, but it is a lot to ask and really risky to be like, so we're going to cast you, and can you sound like Italian, German, French, Roman, like, obviously, you know, like, and we found that she was really the only, literally, I'm not just saying, she was the only choice ever, because not only does she have all that, she's an amazing actress, and look, she's striking.
Yeah, and also when we needed her, you know, we kind of put out this call to all these, basically just a bunch of foreign directors and producers that we knew in Europe, just saying, like, here's the description that we need. And on that description, actually, not just because she's sitting next to me, but on that description it said, look, we need someone who's not just, like, you know, pretty and fits this physical description, but, you know, and is a good actor, of course, you know, but someone that's actually very, very genuinely, in real life, intelligent. You know, somebody that can actually take this role, what it is, that is very, very complicated. It's not just a girl, it's a girl that has this other thing about her that actually would have to, she'd have to internalize, and it's not easy to do. And so she actually showed up on more than one list. And that was one of those, like, yeah. You know, of course, and then we took a look at it, we're like, oh, well, let's talk to her.
You know? So Nadia, now you know that when one sends out emails to a bunch of international producers asking for someone beautiful, intelligent, and charming, they send us back you.
Very good.
Yeah, like all that. Over the world.
So have you tapped into a whole bunch of producers' emails? Are you a kind of sublime hacker?
Maybe.
Oh, wait a second. What?
It was written in the same voice.
Body a choker?
Yeah. They all rhymed with...
Oh, no.
So when was the first time you met these guys, was it?
We met over Skype.
On Skype.
We cast her over Skype.
I know.
And if you've ever done online dating, you know that's like super risky.
It is. And the callback was over Skype as well.
Mm-hmm.
Skype is the future of casting, I think, the now.
Right? Yeah.
Had you ever done that before?
No, first time.
Did you feel like you were online dating a little bit?
I did, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. But we fell in love.
That's a good thing.
I fell in love, yeah.
She fell in love.
I fell. I did. Never.
And so, we're going to talk about Lou Taylor Pucci, who's in the film as well. Mm-hmm. Was huge on the indie scene, obviously, after Thumbsucker kind of blew him out of the water. Mm-hmm. And has done some horror films recently with Evil Dead. Why was he the right kind of counterpoint to Nadia?
Well, you've seen Thumbsucker, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Lou's ability to make you bust up laughing when you just put him in like the most slightly uncomfortable fish out of water situation and put a camera on his face, like the whole crowd goes crazy. Yeah. The scene heading in the third act, I don't want to spoil for you here, but it literally of Lou just sitting in a chair looking uncomfortable got the biggest laugh out of anything in the whole movie.
Yeah.
So there's that, and also, I mean, as far as naturalism goes, along with that dry humor, I mean, there's no one better.
Yeah.
He's amazing, and he's so handsome, they wouldn't even let him in Canada for this.
Yeah.
Is that what happened?
Yeah. They're like, you, sir.
He's like, maybe if I shave? He's like, no, don't shave.
Yeah, no, he also, like, of course, is a director's actor. I mean, he took months preparing for the role, of course, you know, and asked every question in the book and all the right questions and all that. He was perfect. And I heard this wonderful story that apparently after Evil Dead, he was like, so I want to, you know, I mean, he's been relatively, like, youthful in all of his movies, especially Thumbsucker, that's what they know him for, but even in Evil Dead, he's kind of a younger guy, and he's like, I kind of want to become a man in a movie, and I want it and he was talking to his managers before he met us and read the script. He's like, I kind of want a romance, but with, like, a sci-fi bent to it. And they're like, yeah, okay, Lou, that exists, don't worry. And then that script came across to us, like, a week later, and he's like, I want that. So, yeah, he met up with us, and he blew us out away. Yeah.
That's very cool. And just in terms of how you guys got together, like, how did you guys become a thing? How did you guys become
Oh, the two of us?
How'd you guys become Benson and Moorhead?
We were interns at Ridley Scott's commercial production company, and we just started talking. And it was like, we had one day we worked there together.
Yeah. You're like, you're my height.
We're like, and then slowly we start working together more and more, lots of music videos and commercials, spec ads, stuff like that. And then eventually we went off and made resolutions. Turned out we complemented each other really well.
Was it at RSA?
It was RSA, but it should also be said that we were the lowest of low interns. Like, we were like, we were barely interns. Like, they didn't let us into the place where we'll do real stuff. We sat next to the reception desk waiting for them to ask us to make runs.
Yeah, we're like, please, when's the mail coming? I'm so bored. I want to move the mail around.
But was that a stepping stone for you to get into feature films, or were you looking to do commercial?
Only in meeting each other.
Yeah, only
like each other. Because everything we'd done up to that point, and almost everything we did after that point, was always just saving up our own money and shooting stuff, or doing really low budget stuff, like direct to client commercial stuff.
Very cool. So just take it into your own hands and go and do it.
Yeah, like Resolution was paid for with my checking account.
So that's a little healthier now. You can do a better, like another kind of bigger film with it.
Yeah.
With your checking account next time?
I'm not spending my checking account on movies.
Oh, wait, you do that one time.
Do that one time, and then hopefully it's risky. It worked out.
Now, knowing, though, that you can go to these film commissions and get incentives to go and go shoot places, and that they can actually help you make that happen, is there a mind to then kind of expand further in terms of locations and things, or do you feel like you'd like to kind of bring it back home for the next one?
Well, a couple of things on it. One is we don't have an EU passport or anything, so it doesn't give us enough, you know, to really make it all that. But that said, our next movie is an English movie. So, but we're, it's not really, we do produce our own movies, but it, the thought isn't, hey, where's there the money? Let's go make a movie there, you know?
Yeah.
It genuinely is always, it's us screwing around, and then we start talking about something, and then we realize we like the idea, and then we actually, like, turn it into something real.
Yeah.
You know, and so that one was, you know, he saw a guy in France that looked like Aleister Crowley, and he's like, you know who Aleister Crowley is? And then he, like, told me about Aleister Crowley, and I'm like, that guy sounds awesome. And then, you know, like, a few months later, someone else is like, hey, I have an Aleister Crowley movie, and we're like, let's do it, let's rewrite it, let's go see it. And then, so now we're making an Aleister Crowley movie. You know, like, it's always like that, you know, so.
And then just finally, bio.com has a couple of questions that they like asking. One of them is, if you could work with anybody in the world, alive or dead, who would that be?
Nadia Hilker. Lou Pucci.
Sorry for the most middling.
If there was someone who is not involved in your current project, who would it be?
Can I be honest? I don't even know if I'd want him to shoot the movie. I just want to, I don't know. He's just kind of a spiritual thing. It's Deakins.
Okay.
Roger Deakins.
He's going to say Deakins. I'm going to say Daniel Day-Lewis.
That's fair.
Yeah, we make a good movie.
Yeah, we make a good ass movie. Those guys. Yeah. No, Deakins is like watching his movies is like spiritual. It's amazing. So
very cool. Nadia.
Denzel Washington.
Well, we threw you out. You're not gonna
come on. We're right here.
Yeah, she's gone straight for that. If not on person project, but
yeah.
Denzel Washington.
Yeah.
Why?
Oh, well, just right now I spoke to my agent about Man on Fire, and I think that's one of my favorite movies. But also, I think Denzel.
Very cool. Well, congrats again, and we look forward to seeing you next time with the next project.
Awesome.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys.